John Murray Learning, an imprint of John Murray Press, presents How to Live an Awesome Life, the 11-step formula for fulfillment and success, written and read by Ben Coomber. Introduction. What this book is about and what it is not. I don't know about you, but I want to live an awesome life and to be my most awesome self. Sounds simple, right? Yet somewhat arbitrary, like a dream written on a napkin after a few beers. After all, life always seems awesome after a few drinks. Setting the world to rights with a friend, right up until we wake up in the morning with a sore head, sleeping through the alarm and chasing our tail just to make it through the day, all while saying to ourselves, what on earth was I thinking last night? None of that's possible. Back to reality. Now let's level with each other right out of the gate. Who doesn't want to live their best life? You'd be foolish to say no, right? Hopefully you're reading this saying to yourself, yes, Ben, me, I do. You see, I'm just an ordinary guy that took life by the horns and owned it. And you can do the same, if you follow the formula in this book. Everything you want in life, you can have. It starts with dreaming, which most of us do, writing things down and making a plan of action, which some of us do, then taking action, which very few of us do. The dreaming and writing down part of the process is one that most of us enjoy. I find writing down my dreams and goals and working out how I'm going to get there super exciting. I also love doing this when I'm on holiday and have a sense of freedom and space, and I'm relaxed enough to really dream and take the time to explore my thoughts without any external influences or demands on my time. But for most of us, this is where the fear creeps in, when we question whether we can do it, when friends have a joke at our expense, when we have to do some things outside our comfort zone, when we have to work harder. That's normally when we stop, retreat, and go back to the comfort of the status quo. Yet we remain unhappy, frustrated, and dissatisfied, thinking, I want more from life, and making those familiar BS excuses for why it hasn't happened yet. But there is another way. And I promise you, it's possible. I've done it, you can do it. And when I say you can do it, I literally mean everything and anything. Everything life has to offer, you can do. It's simply you choosing to do it and taking the time to execute on the plan. See, I want to live my most awesome life, to have it all. I want to have a fit and strong body, to live with vitality and good health, to go on adventures and travel the world, to have an amazing relationship with my wife, to have awesome kids that grow up to be fulfilled and happy, to have a career that gives me purpose and meaning, to spend time doing what I love, to feel free to live the life that I want to live, to have enough money to not worry about things, to be able to enjoy life and all that it offers, to live well into old age and more. I want it all, and I want you to believe that you can have it all too. This book is about big, achievable goals that shape the life you want to live. That's why it's called How to Live an Awesome Life. It's a book with a big target. It aims to inspire you to go big with your life, to dream and to take action, to have it all, whatever your goals and dreams might be. The reality is, few of us are truly living our best life. Instead, we're hiding behind upbeat selfies and pictures of the life we want our social media to portray, or the narrative we keep telling our friends over a drink through a broken, half-hearted smile. Be honest with me and yourself. Are you truly living the most awesome life possible? Your answers to the following questions might help you work this out. Do you feel happy that life is on track and all is good, or that you're at least working towards that? Do you have energy and passion for life? Do you feel strong mentally and physically? Do you feel positive most days? Do you feel confident as a person and comfortable with who you are? Do you go to work every day feeling inspired and excited, putting out your best self? Do you have enough money to do the things that you want to do? Do you have the body and fitness you want? Do you have the house, car, things that you want, or a method to get them over time? Do you feel you are making an impact on other people's lives? Do you feel alive and have a lust for life? Do you get up excited and curious to face the day? You might have answered yes to some of these and have fulfillment in some areas of your life, or you may feel you have none of those things. Either way, with this book and its 11-step formula, I'm going to inspire you with your own potential, help you create an action plan, and set you on the first steps of your journey and beyond. Notice I'm not using the word success, which you may see in many books like this. Success is defined as the accomplishment of an aim or purpose. The reason I'm not a huge fan of the word success, despite everyone feeling like they know what it means, is that it often has fixed criteria and it's not open to intuitive feedback or individual interpretation, you knowing if you have achieved the goal or not. If we have a goal, it's often shaped by a number, like, I want to lose 4 stone. And it's only when you have lost those 4 stone that you will be happy and feel you have achieved success. I would rather the goal be, I want to lose weight to the point where I look and feel my best self, where I fit into the clothes I want to wear, feel good in my skin, and feel fit and strong. I think this is around 4 stone, but this number is only a rough target. I will know when I'm happy with my weight loss because I will feel like I've completed this journey. This is why I prefer the word fulfillment over success. Many things can make us fulfilled, and if we are always fulfilled in life, we are likely happy. I've never met anyone truly happy who is simply trying to be successful at things. They are just jumping from one goal to the next, never being in a state of fulfillment. Hence my statement about what I want for my kids, to have awesome kids that grow up to be fulfilled and happy. So many say, I want my kids to be successful. What is success anyway? Who is defining it? You? Them? Society? I want fulfillment. I want my kids to be fulfilled in all that they do. And if they turn up to life and do things right, as I try to do, they will likely be successful by default. But it rarely works the other way round. Chasing success rarely leads to fulfillment, but chasing fulfillment and turning up and doing your best every day quite often leads to success. Right, back to the task at hand. Now, I'm not going to bullshit you. There is a lot of work ahead. This is half the reason people fail. They retreat when it gets a little tough. And working on big goals isn't always easy. Getting really fit means you'll have to do some tough workouts. Losing weight means you'll have to say no to some food sometimes. Earning more money means you'll have to put some extra hours in or make some tough decisions about your career. Changing who you are means you have to look at yourself as well as your current beliefs and behaviours, which is really hard, but often needed. Developing deep and meaningful relationships takes time, hard work, and an understanding of others and what makes them happy. All of this takes time, way longer than most of us think or will allow. If you're listening to this audiobook thinking, I've got a load of secrets to fast track you to get all the above in 6 months' time, unfortunately, you'll be disappointed. Shaping your dreams and living your most awesome life requires patience. You've got to be willing to play the long game. With that being said, I hope to get you there much faster. And some of the things I've spoken about can actually be achieved really quickly. More happiness? It starts with a shift in your mindset. Better health? It starts with eating better and looking after yourself. Fitter and stronger? It starts with exercise. You can have so much so quickly if you're prepared to work with this book. Shift your perspective, make the time for new things, and discard old things. This book isn't just about adding new things or creating a new plan. It's also about ditching things that aren't working or serving you. But some of the other things like fulfillment in your career or relationship, building wealth, going on adventures, or growing as a person take far longer. And you need to take a 5 to 10 year view on some of these things. What I hope you notice here is that all the stuff that really matters doesn't take as much time as you think it does to achieve. When people focus on dreams and change, they often focus on things, a house, a car, new clothes. And while all these things are nice and good goals to have, I mean, everyone likes having nice things, ultimately, living an awesome life simply comes down to you. Living an awesome life is a physical and mental state of being, something more ethereal than it is material. It's a state of being where you are happy, fulfilled, challenged, loved, having fun, and doing what you love, all while continuing to grow as a person. This makes you feel alive, and thus you feel awesome. So, while you might have goals like buying your dream home, or going traveling, or changing career, or having kids, you can be happy working towards it. You can enjoy the process. After all, everything in life is a process. We're always moving towards things, so it's important to choose what we move towards and then enjoy the process, the journey, and what it does for us. Life is actually quite long. Most people live past 80 years old, so you have to enjoy the journey as it's a long one. Though, paradoxically, it also seems to flash by, and not all of us are lucky to hit these ages, so we need to make the most of it. This approach to life is often framed as a growth mindset. Being willing and open to change, always developing as a person and enjoying the process of becoming greater. But in the same breath, being grateful for what you have, including the simple things like your health, and being fulfilled with where you're at and what you are doing in life. It's taking stepping stones towards the future while never taking your eye off the beauty of the present. Building a business is a good example. Building a business never stops unless you retire or sell. There isn't a clear endpoint for the company or yourself. You keep growing into the person that can manage it all and get to the next step. I sit here now, writing this as a business owner, someone constantly moving forward and learning the next steps. It's all a journey, and every day I relish the prospect of being challenged by what's coming next. It's also because life isn't a picnic. Life can be really tough at times, so it's important to develop resilience, to be able to take challenges head on, and to know that whatever the challenge may be, you will become a better and stronger person as a result. You either let life shape you into a strong, able, and awesome person who can live a bigger and better life, or you let life control you and defeat you, ending up having a small, limited, unfulfilling life. I know which one I choose. If you listen to this audiobook and implement the 11 core awesome life steps, you can have all you dream of and become everything you want to be as a person. But the key thing is that you have to choose to do the work and apply the lessons in this book, however uncomfortable or hard that work might be. Now, I must repeat, and I will say this a lot, this whole process starts and ends with you. No one in life is going to give you permission to succeed or be fulfilled. You have to give yourself permission. No holy voice is going to sound out through the sky and say, "Yes, you may now go live your best life. Don't worry about him or her or that or what happened in the past. Go achieve and be." That stuff might happen in the movies or in your dreams, but not here on earth in reality. We choose to live our best life. It's time for you to choose. I recognize and appreciate this doesn't feel as simple to do as it is to say in this moment. You may have had parents that weren't always the most supportive of you as a kid, or teachers that told you that you would never amount to anything, or friends that always dismissed anything you ever said you'd do as being daft. These are all things we need to work through, but they are not excuses to settle with a life we don't want. Every one of us has had challenges in life, and while some people do have it easier or harder than others, we have to play the hand we're dealt and make it as good as it can be for ourselves and our families. This book isn't about comparing yourself to me or anyone else you know. It's about you. Only you, and optimizing what you've got. It's that simple. It's the job of this book to help you maximize your personal strengths and abilities while nullifying your sabotaging ways. You likely have some fears and self-doubt, lack long-term thinking and planning, or don't know how to say no to others and yes to yourself. This is what this book aims to do, to either get rid of all of that, or at least shape and control it so it doesn't hold you back. Because I promise you, I literally cannot say this loud enough, you can do it. You can achieve it, but you have to do the work. And at times, it won't be easy. Trust me. Alongside giving you a plan and insights, this book is also here to fire you up and motivate you to continue executing that plan with a constant and evolving vision of how you want your life to be. This is why I use the word awesome all the time, because that's what you and I want our lives to be. So if you're willing to cut the BS, stop blaming things, other people, or circumstances which are out of your control, and take control, shape your future, design it, and take action on it, then you can have it all. See, while there are a lot of things out of our control in life, we have control over one thing, our mindset, and as a result, the way we respond to these things. The story we tell ourselves about our roadblocks are often far more important for determining our outcome than the roadblocks themselves. And so, while it might be easy, even comforting in a paradoxical way, to tell ourselves that we can't because there is something in the way, if we want to make our lives better, we have two choices. Change the story we tell ourselves and join the millions of people who have turned things around from difficult places, or forever wish we took action. This means we need to combine radical acceptance of who we are and where we are in this world with a dogged commitment to changing things regardless of the challenge that presents. It's time to accept who you are, for all that you are. To accept the situation you are in, whatever has happened in the past, and to make a plan to change it and execute boldly on that plan. Because this is how you become fulfilled and successful and live your most awesome life. This is why the first half of this book, which sets the stage for the 11 steps, is quite long. You might have had a skim through and thought, why take so long to get to the 11 steps and the real action, Ben? The reason for this is based on my experience as a coach. Change isn't easy. We have fears. We have problems. We have roadblocks. We have excuses. And most of the things that we want to change, we have attempted before. So just giving you a roadmap won't cut it. I did this with clients in my early years as a coach, and it very rarely works. I need to help you break down fears, teach you to effectively problem solve, help you shift your mindset, and clear the way for the change. So yeah, you could skip to the 11 steps, or even skip to the chapter, or even skip to the chapter summaries. But that will only give you the highlights and not the context and skills to be able to pave the way for big, long-lasting change. So skip ahead by all means. But if you are in the same position in 6 months' time and haven't made the changes you wanted, that might be why. This book is not going to try to change you. It is simply here to help you optimize. You are you. I am me. My strengths and weaknesses as a person are personal to me, and the same can be said for you. So it's not a case of you becoming like me or someone else you deem to be successful, because success and living your most awesome life comes in many forms. I am not here to judge or say how that should look. I am here to show you what is possible, how it is possible, and to help you go away and create that life for yourself over time. Because it will take some time. Big life goals, big change, it happens over months and years. I know firsthand. Some of my big personal goals took a bit of time. For example, it took me 6 months to lose 5 stone of body fat and another 3 months to lose the last half stone. 3 years to put on 3 stone of muscle. 3 years to build a coaching business online before I earned enough money for me to go full-time, and 6 years of working on that business before I had enough money to buy my first home. 7 years to learn how to get over my fear of hurting the woman that I love and committing to the relationship and to her despite my fears. 10 years to build the financial security I wanted before I had kids. Many, many, many years to learn how to be happy and content with what I have while still striving to grow as a person in an enjoyable, patient, and content way. The big things in life often do take time. Please know that. But being 100% honest, you should be able to do it a bit more quickly than I did because you're listening to this audiobook. All these things that I've struggled with for years and years, you could do faster because I'm going to detail what I learned throughout the chapters in this book. Don't struggle any more than you have to. Apply the lessons in this book and go crush life way faster than I did. But I have a caveat. Don't try to do it too quickly because a lot of the benefits are in the process, in the journey. This isn't a book just about achieving things. It's about growing into the kind of person that achieves things and is fulfilled. A lot of the things I have achieved taught me valuable lessons along the way. For example, the process of building muscle develops a confident gym goer in the process. The process of losing body fat and keeping it off develops a confident person in the kitchen and nurtures a healthy relationship with food. The process of building a business develops a good leader and service provider. The process of saving for something makes you learn about investing and putting money away for the future. The process of achieving one goal gives you the confidence to do more, and so the cycle continues. Yes, the end goal is satisfying. Achieving that milestone is something to be celebrated, but the process is where so much of the reward comes from. The journey shapes you, makes you more able, and who doesn't want to be someone who is confident, able, knowledgeable, aware, knowing, and loving? I do. And I know you do too. As I write this book at the age of 35, having achieved a lot, I know I am only a third of the way through my journey. I aim to live to over 100, and I'm excited for the journey to come. Yes, I'll achieve more, but more importantly, I'll grow more as a person. And as I grow, I can help myself more, help my friends more, support my family more, contribute to society and my communities more, and that is awesome. For me, that is a fulfilling life. And what underpins your level of life fulfillment? You. You are the asset that you need to develop. I've read countless books on personal development over the years because of the value that they can bring to your life. And now I'm the guy writing one after having had the dream of doing so for so long. But it all started with a weight loss goal and simply wanting to better myself. Where will your journey start or end? Only you can decide. That's the awesome thing about life. It's only going to take you exciting places when you go all in and choose to become the best version of yourself. I promise that when you choose yourself, when you challenge yourself, when you develop yourself, when you are constantly learning and evolving and willing to change, you will be living an awesome life. Life should evolve. Life should change. Life should go through stages. Life should go up and down and around. And that's what makes life interesting. How many people do you see as stuck in life? Stagnant, just going through the motions, not necessarily sad, but also not happy, just meh. They don't have enough to look forward to. They aren't moving towards a new goal. They aren't growing or being challenged with what's next. Maybe you feel that way right now. Please don't think that you always need to be working towards something grand in life. You don't. Life isn't a perpetual race to acquire more things, titles, and acclaim. When I say we want to be moving forward with life by growing and being challenged, it might be you learning how to grow your business, but it might also be you working to bring your local community together more, to be a better parent, to forge stronger relationships, or how to grow a vegetable patch in your garden so you can show your kids the value of real food. Growing and learning means we are never stagnant, that we are always passionate about life and what it can bring. And if you ever feel that you aren't, change must happen. Now, I can give you all the examples in the world, but all this stuff is personal to you and me as individuals. I can tell you what I love, what it means to live an awesome life for me, and what I might think will lead you towards an awesome life, but ultimately only you can piece this all together and work out what living an awesome life means to you. What I want is for you to know what you truly want and for you to use this book to help you shape your future. Because I don't want you to go another day not working towards a better future. You deserve it. We all deserve it. This is the incredible thing about being human in the digital information age. There is no information we don't have access to anymore. You can learn how to do anything. Medicine has increased our life expectancy. We can travel anywhere and everywhere. We can do any job we care to dream of. We can pretty much contact anyone in the world with enough effort. For many of us, there is an almost obscene amount of abundance and opportunity. And that abundance, those opportunities, are only going to improve as technology levels the playing field even more. So I'll ask again, what does living an awesome life mean to you? What do you want? Who do you want to be? What do you want to change? I'd like you to start to think about that. I want this introduction to start off the process of you dreaming, wishing, and wanting. I don't mind if you pause this audiobook for a couple of weeks to think about that, because we are now looking at big life decisions, and such decisions shouldn't be made lightly. It takes time, so please don't rush it. There's no pressure, not from me anyway. So please don't put that pressure on yourself. It's often when we rush things, we make the wrong decisions. So take it slow. Big things in life take big thinking. Take the time you need. It's funny that the question of what do you want to do in life always ends up with someone talking about their career path, or more specifically, that one job. I used to hate that question as a kid. It was as if you had to say, I want to be a lawyer, doctor, accountant, or insert whatever high status, high paying job you like. And that was your life, your future, all done and dusted. All you were meant to aspire to was your job. That was it, your life. Fuck that. As people, we are not a job or a career. That is not our whole identity. That is a small part of our identity. Life is many things. We are many things. After all, we are human. Life is work. Life is health. Life is love. Life is fun. Life is adventure. Life is sleep. Life is eating. Life is laughing. Life is moving. Life is for growing. Life is for living. Life is about so much more. And this is why there is so much to talk about in this book. I've been stuck at many points in my life, sat there thinking, what's next? But the only way to find out is to carry on and be a little patient, to keep growing and challenging yourself, to keep walking through doors and taking new opportunities that come up, to keep seeking change, challenge, and growth. Do that and you'll find that the path ends up going in a pretty cool direction. My big life shift was losing 5.5 stone of body fat. That transformation of my physical body changed my life. The act of becoming healthier, losing unwanted body fat and getting really fit. All of that was incredible. But it made me curious as to what else I could change. It made me seek more. If I could eat less, eat more healthily, adjust my lifestyle to have more healthy habits, and feel this good, then wow, give me some more. I'm in. That one transformation made me want to transform many other areas of my life and turn my body and mind into the ultimate tool. And guess what? It's your turn. You are the tool. You are the vehicle. You are the person that is going to shape your future life with zest and passion. It's time to unlock your potential. It's time to develop the tools and insights to succeed, achieve, and be fulfilled. It's time to build your awesome life. Ready? Pumped? Awesome. Let's go. Part 1. Doing the groundwork. Chapter 1. So what is an awesome life? This book is about you, but at this point I feel I need to introduce myself a little more. Otherwise you might not believe me and get what this living an awesome life is all about. It could be easy for me to write a book and just say these things, to paint the picture but not to have lived the story. But I am writing this book because I feel I have lived an awesome life for 15 plus years and I feel empowered to inspire others to do the same. Once you're convinced that I know what I'm talking about, I'm going to outline why most people hold themselves back, how you can approach your fears, think more critically, and problem solve, all while telling stories that should give context and real-world meaning to my points. This should set the stage for the next part of the book, which explains the 11 steps in the Awesome Life formula. So here we go, a little bit more about me. So why is my life so awesome? I'm writing this book with a great feeling of calm, satisfaction, and gratitude for my life. If that's not a life being well lived, what is? You might have picked up this book thinking it was going to be one of those usual motivational, career, money books where the guy or girl writing it, if you check them out on their social media, is living the life. But I'm not the guy with £4-5 million homes dotted around the world with garages full of luxury cars, who holidays 8 times a year in exotic locations, who buys his partner diamond jewellery on a whim while passing through the airport, who owns every Rolex just because he can, who has a housekeeper do everything around the home, who works just 2 hours a day trading the markets. I am not that guy. Jeez, that guy sounds painful. And if that's what you see as successful, as the ultimate goal, as the trappings of having arrived in life, we're in trouble. That's the type of crap you see flaunted on social media. The watches, the holidays, the houses, the cars, the money stuff. Those are the outlandish purchases that only intimate a person is successful, but doesn't necessarily mean anything beyond that. They just mean that someone has money, and yes, a lot of it. It's also emblematic of what I feel is so wrong about the modern age of social media. We can portray the life people want to see whether or not we're actually happy while living it. And a lot of people do that. So make sure you follow the right people online, because there are a lot of insufferable people out there just playing some warped status game. Trust me, I've spoken to a lot of them. Many of them aren't happy. They aren't fulfilled. They are empty inside. I'm a simple guy with simple, meaningful, to me, dreams. So who am I, and what has led me to sitting here feeling a great sense of calm, satisfaction, and gratitude for my life? I am fit, healthy, and strong. I understand myself, my unique abilities, and how to use them to get the most out of life. I have ADHD, which became an issue when I was studying at university, but got help with it, learned how to manage it, did the work, and now use my ADHD as an asset to my business. I used to have IBS, eczema, and asthma when I was younger, which I worked to solve once I left high school, and spent over 14 months in 2020 and 2021 battling to recover from long COVID, which also resulted in me having to undergo testosterone therapy, rehabilitate my gut health, and battle back from clinical depression in 2021-2022. I know what health recovery looks like and how challenging it can be. I've had a great career to date, being awarded Health Coach of the Year 2019, Nutrition Coach of the Year 2020 and 2021, multiple awards for the supplements I've created. Awesome supplements, should you wish to check them out. I've written for most of the UK media publications and newspapers, have been on TV and in the news a few times, have had a number one rated UK podcast, top 10 globally also, which has also allowed me to inspire many people and connect with some of the greatest minds on the planet. I've helped thousands of people change their lives via my podcasting, writing, coaching, and my online programs. I run a group of companies that collectively, in the year of writing, should turn over £2 million, which, if sold, could see me retire if I wanted to with the money I would net. Otherwise, financially, I never have to worry about money or spending. My wife doesn't have to work and can focus on being a full-time mum to our 2 daughters. I'm not a millionaire, but I'm comfortable. And day to day, I don't want or need for much. Funnily enough, a comfortable life like mine takes a lot less money than people think. More on this later. I've travelled most of Europe, Asia, and Central America, as well as many other incredible places, both with my work and for pleasure. I have a happy, healthy family with a beautiful home in a lovely part of the UK and just a few minutes from all our friends and family. I do work that I'm passionate about and which gets me fired up every day. I work in a very flexible way, never missing anything to do with my kids, and enjoy every aspect of my life. I am confident, calm, balanced, happy, fulfilled, and constantly excited about the future. If I did happen to die today, I would die a happy man, knowing that the years I have lived, I went all in on and made the most of it. I see every day as an opportunity to learn, have fun, experience life in all its ups and downs, while continuing to challenge myself. I am living an awesome life. What I'm saying, in short, is that I'm a pretty normal guy, I think, who has a pretty normal aspiration for living a good, awesome life. So what's my criteria for this? I want to be happy, content, and fulfilled. I want to be fit, strong, and resilient. I want my family to be happy and healthy and laugh lots. I want to provide everything my kids need to thrive. I want a nice house to enjoy and raise my kids in. I want a car that works and I don't have to worry about it. I want the money to go on adventures and have experiences. I want to be able to afford good food, both for health and for pleasure. I want to be able to help my family when they need it. I want to have to not worry about money. I want to do work I'm passionate about and positively affects the world. I want to have the freedom of choice and time and not be bound by any external forces. I want a free mind devoid of pain, anxiety, clutter, or ill feelings towards others. I want it all. This for me is living an awesome life. It's a delicate balance of things, experiences, and a state of mind. I have it, and I want to share with you how you can also have it. Exercise. What is your awesome life? This is the first exercise of many in this book, where you will define what living an awesome life looks like for you. So either grab a notepad and pen and write down these questions and fill in your answers, or go to the free download that accompanies this audiobook, where you'll find all the exercises and can follow along. Now, the exercise we're about to do we'll also revisit later in this book, as it might change as you read on. As I share more perspectives, insights, and teachings, you might find your definition shifts or deepens, or how that life materializes. So forgetting what living an awesome life is to me, write down, whether it's a list of bullet points or a paragraph of text, what you think living an awesome life is to you. Do that now. How did you feel writing that down? Motivated? Excited? Unsure? As though there is a lot of work to do or far away from where you want to be? That it all feels a little wishy-washy right now? I want you to have a mixture of these emotions, because that would be a truthful place to be. There is no point being so motivated and inspired that you're blind to the reality of the path ahead, because when you know and see what the path is, you will know there is a fair chunk of work to do. But that's okay. As I've said, this stuff isn't going to take a few weeks to put in place. Some bits will. There are plenty of quick wins we can have to get you living a much more awesome life quickly, but many other things will take time, and that's expected. Back to me, and we'll focus on you really soon. Now, I don't want to focus on me too much, because this book is about you. But I need you to have confidence you're in good hands. You might have discovered this book while having a little scroll before you go on holiday for a holiday read and have no idea who I am, or got recommended it by a slightly crazy friend of yours and be listening with trepidation, or got given it as a gift at Christmas and are listening just in case they ask you later what you got out of it. So here goes. I started my own personal development journey at the age of 18. When I finished school, I was very overweight, so much so that I was classified as obese. I also suffered with ADHD, asthma, eczema, and IBS, and had done so throughout my teenage years. As a result, I was bullied all through senior school for being fat, and what was coined a thespian. That's a person who's into the arts and acting and quite flamboyant, which wasn't a popular thing at my school, a military boarding school. School at times was really tough, and in the back of my mind, I always wanted to change, to do something about it, to realise my potential. But I lacked confidence, know-how, and support beyond my mum, who was always awesome and supportive. Thanks, mum. Bullying can do two things. It can make you retreat into yourself, the most common outcome, and cause you to lack self-worth, or it can make you want to fight back, be better, and prove them wrong. I chose the latter. Screw letting the bully's words define who I was or who I was going to be. Once I left school and got my first job as I started to pursue my dream of becoming an actor, I started to have thoughts of change, largely focused around my health and fitness. Early on, I took simple steps. Although I had finished my secondary school, I was still at the military school because my mum worked there, and I was lucky because the school had facilities we could use, beautiful surroundings, playing fields, a gym, swimming pool, etc. So I started to run a few times a week and visited the school gym. This was me simply starting to say, I want to better myself. I don't want to go into the big, wide world and continue to get bullied for being overweight, to always be picked last playing sport, to not feel confident in myself. During that summer, I got a bit fitter and lost a tiny bit of weight, but it wasn't a lot at all. Maybe 4 or 5 pounds from a whole summer of training. It was frustrating as I was putting in a decent amount of effort, but the thing holding me back was my diet. I wasn't eating well enough, and ultimately, I was still eating too much. Boarding school does a good job of feeding you up. After a few months of this, we moved. Because I had finished school, my mum felt it was time to move on. She originally got the job because she was divorced and wanted to continue to put my brother and I through private school. What a sacrifice and clever move. Thanks again, mum. I'll be forever grateful. So with a new partner, they bought a house in our local town and we all moved from the school to Ipswich, Suffolk, in the east of England. I continued on this fitness journey while starting to do auditions for drama school. The auditions weren't going well. My weight loss wasn't going well. And in the midst of all of that, I had a big argument with my brother one day at home, someone I always bullied and argued with because, one, I was his older brother by 4.5 years and you often do that as a big brother. Two, as a deflection of the bullying I used to receive at school, probably to make myself feel better. My brother was a bit chubby too at the time, so I deflected the fat jokes I got at school on him. Classic bully behaviour. One afternoon, I was bullying my brother about his weight while we were making food in the kitchen, and something I said was the straw that broke the camel's back. My brother fought back, and rightly so, but this time in a big way, saying stuff like, "You're far from perfect, bro. Look at how fat you are. Look at all this fitness and running you're doing, and you're not even losing any weight. You keep getting rejected from drama school. Nothing you're doing is working. You're failing big time, so fuck off." After 17 years, I can't remember his exact words, but it was along those lines. And guess what? It hurt badly. But after the frustration and anger wore off, the facts showed themselves. It was all true. And I wanted to react. I wanted to do better, to be better, to find a better way. I knew there was a way. People lose weight and crush their goals all the time. I just had to find out why I wasn't achieving my goals. I had to find out the flaws in my methods. I also considered what this goal would mean for my career. I had been unsuccessful both with my career ambitions and my fitness and weight loss ambitions, and perhaps they were connected. Perhaps if I got fit, lost weight, and built up my self-confidence, my chances of acting school success would improve. Moving on. So I developed this mantra in my head. If I get fit and lose weight, I'll be successful in my career. And that was it. Because I was 18 and I was in that discovering myself phase of life, this really drove me on. I now had this singular focus to prove everyone wrong, because I'd been told my whole life that acting was a stupid career path to follow, that studying science, maths, and English was the way to go. Yet I just wasn't good at those things. I was good at the arts. And you know what? This made me step up my actions in a big way. It was enough for me to go and find the answers I needed. My mindset was halfway there. I was already taking action and doing a lot of the work to change my circumstances, but my tools were broken. The things I was doing, mainly my eating, weren't right. So if I could find the answers, I could and would be successful with these goals. Side note, if you're not finding success with something in your life, one of two things is ultimately the problem. Either your strategy is wrong or your tools are inadequate, or both. For me, the effort was there, but the tools were just not up to the job. This led me to problem solve and think, where do I find people that know a lot about health, fitness, and losing weight? Ah, of course, the gym. So I took a good chunk of my then earnings and I committed to going to the gym and getting the advice I needed to achieve my goals. The effort was there. This was me finding better tools. When I joined the gym, I was very fortunate to get a gym induction by a great coach named Ben Gray, with whom I'm still friends today. He gave me some great lifestyle advice, told me to buy a book that was hot at the time on nutrition called How to Eat, Move and Be Healthy by Paul Check, and wrote me out a fitness plan. The plan consisted of hitting the gym 4 days per week, doing 30 minutes of cardio and 1 hour's weight training. I then added 30 minutes of core training too, because I wanted a six pack. Reading the book and applying the diet advice in it, getting good sleep, hydrating well, being as active as possible day to day, and avoiding drinking too much alcohol. That was the plan, and it was a huge improvement on my previous one, which was not much more than eat more healthily and get more exercise. This was also alongside starting to play rugby again, as I love sport and it's a great way to meet new friends, which meant training twice per week and playing a game at the weekend. Now, all of this was a little extreme in terms of how much exercise I was doing, but I had the desire and the energy to do it at the time, as well as very few other commitments in my life. So I went hard at it. Guess what? It worked. Through my improved eating habits and with weight training rather than just cardio, I lost 5 stone in 6 months, with the last half a stone taking 2 to 3 months more. I was a new man as a result. This saw me grow very quickly as a person, to be a lot more confident in myself, be really fit, get rid of my eczema and reduce my IBS symptoms too, and I started to really believe I was made for great things. Getting fit and healthy really was a game changer and is ultimately, as you will find in this book, the foundation for everything you want to achieve in your life. If you want energy and vitality, you need to be as healthy as possible. If you want to lose body fat and feel good, you need to eat good food and less of it to lose weight. No fad diets, just good, normal, balanced meals. If you want to be strong, mentally and physically, You need to do things that make you stronger, like lifting heavy things or doing physical and mental challenges. If you want to move well, look after your body, take care of it and how it moves. If you want to feel good day on day, prioritise good sleep. The book I read to help with all of this ultimately gave me all the foundations I needed to live a good, productive, healthy life. And because this was such a life-changing book for me, it showed me the power of the written word. Just one book, read cover to cover, and its lessons applied to my life, changed my life. The same could be for you listening to this book. Gaining so much value from a book turned me into an avid reader. School had almost made me hate reading because I rarely read anything I actually wanted to read. So much of school was spent reading Shakespeare plays, history about Henry VIII, how to tackle algebra and the nuances of the periodic table, all the stuff I had to learn just to pass a test or exam. I think the school system needs an overhaul, but that's for another book. The reading I did at school never felt like it was driven by real interest or real world application, so I rarely read any non-fiction books outside of school. But now I had read this book, I was hooked. I felt that if this book gave me this much value and had changed my life this much, and it only cost me £15, there was an entire world of books out there ready to discover. I went to the library and found more books on health and fitness. Yeah, the internet wasn't as much of a thing back then like it is now. I devoured what I could for free from the library, then started buying some from the local bookshop. This, along with a few other life events, led me to abandon acting as a career and train to become a personal trainer and nutrition coach. What I had learned and applied to myself was life-changing stuff, and I wanted to coach other people to do the same, to change their lives just as I had changed mine. So at the age of 19, I started doing personal training and nutrition courses from the very guy who wrote that book, Paul Check. And because I was working hard doing two jobs, I was able to afford to fly to California and study directly under him at his facility. A year later, after much study, I became a personal trainer working one-to-one helping other people. But I'll be honest, I didn't get very good results. I felt like I knew what to do and knew how to make a plan, but I'd barely scratched the surface. I didn't understand people and the nuances of coaching and behaviour change, so I rarely got people to achieve their goals. So I went through the same process again. Okay, I'm failing here, I told myself. I'm not getting the results I expect, but I am applying effort. So it's not an effort problem, but an understanding problem, a lack of education. I made the decision to go to university and study sports coaching and performance. My motivation here was threefold. One, I knew I wanted to study the human body inside and out so I could be better at my job. A degree that covers aspects of physiology, biology, biomechanics, sports nutrition, and coaching would do this. Two, I wanted to go to a place that had a lot of opportunities, which universities do. Opportunities I knew I wouldn't get in my hometown continuing to do what I was doing. Three, I wanted to have fun, explore things, people, and the world. And coming from a small town with not a lot going on, I felt moving away to university was a good way to do this, to really fly the nest. At this point, I'll cut a long story short and pick up the parts of my journey later where they're relevant. The point here is to stress the power that just one book had on me and how it stimulated in me the desire to learn, evolve, and grow as a person. I've taken this approach to everything I've ever done. If I've wanted to know something or learn something quickly, I've simply bought a book or several books on a topic, talked to people who know a lot about the topic, and learned everything I could to get the outcome I wanted. A book must be an axe for the frozen sea within us. Franz Kafka. a Swiss Army knife approach to life. On that topic, it's important to try not to learn without aim. Instead, try to learn with purpose. I remember in the early days of personal development, my learning was all about nutrition and fitness. But as soon as I felt I had learned what I needed to learn, first for myself and then to help my clients, I shifted my learning to sports nutrition and behavioural psychology. Then, when I started my business, my learning shifted to business. Then, when I had issues growing my business, it shifted to marketing and sales, and then over time to leadership, to finance and wealth building. Then, as I prepared to have kids, to parenting and stoic philosophy. Ultimately, we learn things that are relevant to changing or improving our situation. And as we evolve in our lives, our learning needs will change, and that is a good thing. This approach has led me to become a good and proud generalist. I know a fair bit about nutrition, health, fitness, mindset, behaviour and habit change, career success, business success, relationships, parenting, productivity and technology, but I'm no expert or specialist in any of these areas. I know enough to help 95% of people to improve themselves in these areas, and I've chosen to do this because I want to help a large number of people. It also feeds my ADHD and my brain's huge appetite for stimulation. It's a win-win. What I want you to get from this book is the skills I have developed as a life generalist. This book won't help you develop any hyper-specific areas of business or your career, for example. See, I'm no engineer, and so I can't help you progress your knowledge in engineering. But what I can help you with is your approach to your career and how you can develop it in a broader way. And this will help you to become a more successful and better engineer. Just like I can help you with your nutrition, fitness, health, relationship building, and many more areas fundamental to being your most awesome self and building your awesome life. It's the broader skill set that's important. The specifics can come.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.